kaibigan. Kaya, tayong lahat ay mga kaibigan ni Joma dahil una, humahanga tayo sa kanyang katalinuhan. Pangalawa, humahanga ako ng personal sa kanyang mga inadvice at sa kanyang paghihirap dahil hindi madaling mawala at umalis at manatili sa ibang bansa, hindi lamang sobrang lamig, kundi talagang alam ko ang kanyang hangarin makabalik dito. At pangatlo, ako'y humahanga kay Joma dahil siya lang ay isa sa napakakaunting taong hindi bumabaliktad o hindi nabibili ang prinsipyo at maski anong harassment na gawin sa international arena hanggang tawagin siyang teroristya sa hanay ni, anong pangalan niya? Nung kami huling mag-pulong, which was some time ago, sa favorite Chinese restaurant niya, sabihin kung saan, nung kami na sa abroad, ay sabi nga niya, oy, ito mga takot makita kasama ko. Kaya terrorista ako, pali din natin. Sabi ko, kaya hindi ako sa kanila. Anyway, I am glad that we have this event, which features the writings of the highly esteemed Professor Jose Maria Suson. For so long, he has launched his idea of changing Philippine society by educating our people, persuading us to fight for democracy and for our common aspiration of a better life that is free from oppression, including hunger, deprivation, and disease. These aspirations have inspired Professor Suson to write volumes of books, some of which have been featured by the Aklat ng Bayan. In his writings, Professor Suson constantly reminds the Filipino people to continually struggle against oppression in all its forms. And for me, Joma's admonition to leaders of our country to let the Filipino people decide their fate rings most relevantly during this crucial campaign period when the people will be choosing their leaders in all levels of governance. Through his writings, Joma reminds us what leadership is all about. Leadership is not just all about popularity, it is not all about personalities. Leadership is all about the masses of the Filipino people and those who truly work to help them in their daily fight for living decently and free from the yoke of poverty. In these volumes, as in all his writings, Joma talks on the struggles of our people. Indeed, our people are struggling on a daily basis just to make both ends meet. We all know the social weather station has said an increase of 24% of Filipinos who suffer from hunger. This means 4.4 million households, or approximately 20 million, or one-fourth of our population, did not have enough to eat in the past year. And to me, and I have no doubt, to Professor Suson too, the Filipino people do not deserve this situation. But of course, I am not here to lecture you on what you already know about. All I'm saying is that Joma's musings and writings and literature is something that amazes us because it is something that has been consistent all these years, if not decades, which just shows the consistency of the degradation and deprivation of the Filipino people in us in all these years. Kaya po, bagamat ako'y nagagalak sa kanyang kagalingan, sa kanyang pagsulat, ako rin ay nalulungkot dahil hindi nagbabago. Maaaring nagbabago, pero hindi para sa kabutihan at hindi para umasenso ang buhay sa kanyang mga sinusulat. Kaya ako'y isang hamon bilang isang leader ng ating bansa, bilang isang halal ng bayan na agapan ang mga problema. Kahapon lang, nung kami nasa Calamba at nagpunta sa mga merkado ng Binyan ng Santa Rosa, ang mga sinasabi ng tao, ang kanilang mga pangarap at hangarin sa buhay ay napakapaya. Sinasabi nila, ang gusto lang po namin pambili ng gamot at pero silang palaging pinapakitang pambili reseta. At sabi nila, bakit po sa commercial sinasabi, mababa na ang presyo ng gamot, bakit po sa amin, mahal pa rin. At maski po, ibabaan ng konti ang presyo ng gamot, ay kung kami naman po ay walang trabaho at mamamatay na, wala pa rin ang pambili ng gamot. Maliban doon, sabi na kami may kumakain minsan ako dalawang beses isang araw at malaki ang kakulangan. This is the human face of poverty that we see perhaps not only during campaign periods but every day of our lives. and this is something which we must do something about in all levels of governance, whether in the private sector, in the academy, or in politics. In fact, just today, I attended the Makati Business Club meeting where my presidential candidate was a guest speaker. And we talked about the same case of poverty which the business community in Makati must face. So whether you are in UP or in Makati Business Club or in the hinterlands in various parts of Mindanao, it's the same case of poverty that confronts us daily. And this is a kind of oppression, I believe, that Joe Masison tells us about. Maaring tayo ay nakamit na. Nakamit na natin ang ating kalayaan. We were able to liberate ourselves and we are now free as a people, but I believe, and we all, I'm sure, will agree that there is no complete freedom from the oppression if we, or at least half of our population, live on only $1 or 50 pesos a day. So on this occasion, I thank all of you for having me here today. It is a highly esteemed group, and to be considered a friend of a great Filipino and a brilliant man and a loyal, extremely loyal friend, I thank you for being here today. I felt called my good friend last Monday, February 8th on his birthday. I will do so tonight. I know that even if we are miles apart and don't call each other as often as friends should do, Joma's and my, our friendship goes beyond boundaries and borders. We may not be on the same political terms all the time, and we may not agree on everything all of the time, but there are a couple of things, and those are the most important things in life that Joe and I agree on. First is social justice. Dapat magkaroon ng maayos na programa at pamahalaan para magkaroon ng mas maayos na pataypantay ng ating mga nahihirap na Pilipino. So social and equitable distribution of wealth is something that John and I have always talked about and agree on. And of course, primordial consideration, of course, is the upliftment of her poverty of our long-suffering Filipinos. And third, of course, is a desire for a genuine, authentic, and lasting peace, not only in Mindanao, but all over the country. In fact, sabi ni Joma, well, I shouldn't say this, it should be off the record, maybe we should have known. It's a testament of our friendship and of his faith in my capability. It's a great honor to be to have said such words from a great man like Joma Sison. Who am I compared to Joma, who suffered so much for the Filipino people, who continues to suffer from persecution from the Philippine government and from the U.S. government and other governments, his host government as well. But I'm glad that he has friends like those present here today who give him tributes such as this, who gives honor for his talent and his brilliance and his dedication to the Filipino people. I think I've said too much. We politicians talk too much when there is a microphone. But I thank you all for having me here today. Kaya sa ating kapatid, kaibigan, kakampi na si Joma Sison, isa kang dakilang Pilipino, isa kang dakilang bayani, isa kang kapalit na kaibigan, isa kang kaibigan na hindi natin iwan, na napaka